Hi, my name's Mary. Today I'm going to show you how you can copy an existing garment. I'm going to be showing you this today on the silhouette system by Gerber Technology, but you can do the same thing on paper. All of the principles still apply. This is the garment we're going to use today. So let's look at it first before we start copying it to see what we're working with. The first thing I notice when I look at this garment is the grain for the bodice goes along this neckline. We want to keep that in mind when we copy this pattern. It has basic darts in the front. It has gussets, no set-in sleeve, but a seam that comes all the way down the sleeve to the hem. It's got darts in the back, a zipper, and of course the grain here is parallel to the zipper. And it's got little tucks here for the bodice. Now, there's different ways you can use to copy a garment. You can take the dress apart, lay the patterns down on the table, and copy the shapes. But often, you really don't want to take the garment apart. You need to keep it assembled. So in this way, you can also lay the garment down and copy the shapes of the patterns. You can also use a tape measure and measure the existing measurements of the patterns and then draft the patterns on the paper. So I'm going to use a combination of these different methods together. Now I've taken our dress, I've turned it inside out and laid it flat on the table. There is a kick pleat in the back of the dress, and I've found that this fabric, because it's so old, is very fragile, and rather than pinning it shut, I've taped it. You can also use pins on this silhouette table and pin the garment, but again, this fabric is very fragile and I'm going to tape it in place instead. Now, oftentimes when you've got the garment still sewn together, you can't get the whole piece laid flat at the same time. So what you need to do is walk around the pattern and capture a piece at a time, because you can only get a part of it flat at one time. With this particular skirt, even though it's got darts, the whole pattern does lay flat on the table at once. Now all I need to do is get it all smooth and flat and then trace around the outside and the dart locations. I'm going to do the front skirt. I always like to start with the easiest piece. And if you were doing this manually without a computer, you would just lay the garment on top of a piece of paper, and you can use a pin to poke through the seam location and create the outline shape on the paper. Here I've got my AccuMark system, so I'm going to use the function in the draft menu called Line Curve. And it's going to create the shape for me as I select my locations around the sew line of this dress. So I'm starting with the hem. Now I've got that location defined, and I'm just simply going to go up the side seam location, and I can smooth out the curve shapes when I'm done. I don't have to worry too much about it as I work. Now I've come up to the waist location, which is raised, and now I'm at my other side seam. There are pockets in this skirt, but I can indicate the location of those pockets later. Now I've completed the outline shape for my skirt. So now we're going to get the location and the shape of the dart on the front of the skirt. Now this dart sews to zero on both ends. It's a fisheye dart, and that's why this skirt will lay flat on the table even though it has darts sewn in it. So now I'm indicating the location, and then later I'll use a tape measure to figure out the width of the dart and build the rest of the dart shape into the pattern. The sleeve and the bodice are one piece for the front and the back, and it has got gussets. So this is a case of a pattern where you cannot lay down the whole thing flat at one time to get its shape. So what we need to do is copy just a portion at a time, the portion that we can get to lay flat. And again, I'm going to tape it to the table because the pin does not go through this fragile fabric very well, and we don't want to tear it. Sometimes it's helpful if you On your paper, you draw guidelines to represent the grain, so you've got nice straight lines that you can follow when you're pinning or taping your garment down to make sure that everything's nice and square. Now, I've got as much of this pattern flat as I can get. So what I'm going to do is sneak in to where the sew lines are to find my seam locations. So here I'm starting at the top of the gusset, coming down to the underarm location to the side seam, then across the waistline, up the zipper location, and my back neckline to the shoulder seam. So now, in order to continue on with the back bodice and get the sleeve, I'm going to release the area of the back bodice at the center back and then smooth down the location of the sleeve to get my shape. So starting where I left off before at the shoulder back neck intersection, I'm going to come along and follow this shoulder seam down to the hem. Now, the way this has been created, the front sleeve pattern at the wrist is shorter than the back sleeve pattern. So I can't really get the whole thing to lay flat well right now. I'm going to add that amount that I'm missing later. Come back up to the gusset location, and now I've made it back to my starting point at the underarm location. Okay, now we're going to do the front bodice. I've taped down the front neckline location, which was the one that's parallel or perpendicular to the grain of the garment. And we're going to start at the dart location for the front bodice. And because of this dart, we can't get the whole pattern to lay flat at the same time on the table. So we're going to start at this dart, go along the sew lines, and the edge of the front neck up to the shoulder, and then along the shoulder seam and through the different layers of the dress. That's okay, it won't affect my final pattern. And I'm going to come all the way down here to the wrist, and then we'll come back up under the underarm location, back to the gusset location. Now at this point, because of the dart, I've got to release the part of the garment that I have taped down and lay the remainder of it flat. And since I don't want to pin this garment, I'm just going to use my hands to keep it in place. Back down to the underarm side seam location, and then back along the remainder of the waist to the dart at the front bodice. Okay, now I'll show you how to make the gusset. In this case, it's made from a rectangle, so we don't have to go all the way around the outline. All I really need to do is measure the length of the gusset and then make a rectangle that size, which is 4.5 inches or 12 centimeters, and then cut that rectangle in half and add a little curve shape to represent the underarm location. So now I've got my completed pattern. I've cleaned it up after initially entering it into the system and gone through and verified the dimensions and made sure that my finished pattern meets the dimensions of the garment itself. Had you been working yourself with paper and a pin, once you pin the outline of your seam allowance and the shape of the patterns, you just take a pencil and do connect the dots and connect the pin locations, and that's how you get your finished pattern shapes. And here's our finished sample, first sample of the garment. And I'd like to thank Faith from Never Say Goodbye Antiques in Higginham and Middletown, Connecticut for letting us borrow the beautiful red vintage dress to copy. I hope you found this video an informative overview of the process. Thank you.